Hi, I'm Kelsey Green. Welcome to this month's hashtag All the Feels. My God, why have you forsaken me? If you ever thought this or said this in a prayer, let me tell you that you are in good company. This month, we are focusing on Psalm 22 and discussing the emotion of abandonment. This is an emotion that is well known by all, whether we want to admit it or not. We have all struggled with the feeling of being abandoned. Maybe you have felt abandoned by your family, your spouse, your friends, or even by God. As we walk through Psalm 22, you will see that you are not alone in feeling these emotions of abandonment. You do not have to stay in this place of feeling abandoned, and God has provided a way of hope for all of His children. As I mentioned earlier, you are in good company if you have ever questioned God for forsaking you. This was the exact question King David asked God in Psalm 22:1. And we also go on to read in the New Testament, Jesus asked this very question of God as He is dying on the cross in Matthew 27:46 and Mark 15:34. God is not taken aback or shocked when we feel forsaken by Him. He understands and He sympathizes with every emotion we have. In these times of trouble, God is asking us to come closer to Him, but it is those around us that push the wedge of isolation. Back in the ancient world, there is a belief held by many called the doctrine of divine retribution. The essence of this doctrine was that if you were successful and wealthy, then God liked you. However, if your life was filled with pain and difficulty, then there was bound to be hidden sin in your life, and you must be under the judgment of God. This belief was pushed onto King David in Psalm 22. This belief was also pushed onto Jesus on the cross while others jeered and mocked Him, saying that if He really was the Son of God, then He would be saved. We also see this in Job 18:4-5, and it says, "You who tear yourself in your anger, shall the earth be forsaken for you, or the rock be removed out of its place? Indeed, the light of the wicked is put out, and the flame of his fire does not shine." Job's friend is reminding him that only the wicked are punished, and he needs to come to terms with whatever sin he has committed and make it right. We know this doctrine is false, but still today, there are many Christians and non-Christians alike that live with this mindset. We live in a mindset and misconception that God is out to take revenge on us, get back at those who have sinned, that God must have the last laugh. However, our God is not that kind of God. We live in a fallen world where tragedy and negative emotions strike all the time. There are times when God is silent and feelings of being forsaken, abandoned, and hopeless creep in. But those are not the times to bow down to those feelings. Instead, we must lean into God, lean into community, and lean into the everlasting hope of Christ. In times of feeling abandoned, it is our urge to isolate and retract from others. But in Hebrews 10:24-25, it urges us to go another direction. It says, "And let us consider how to stir up one another to love and good works, not neglecting to meet together, as is the habit of some, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day drawing near." We are encouraged to meet together, not neglecting how important community is in the Christian walk. In the community of others is when we find the strength to persevere through life's difficulties. If you are like the millions, maybe even billions of other people in the world that love to watch the Olympics, then you probably saw one of the most memorable Olympic moments take place at Rio 2016 at the 5,000 meter women's run. The race is in full swing. The women have already run 3,000 of the 5,000 meters. They're on the tail end of it, and two runners, one from New Zealand and one from the United States, are entangled with each other and both take a bad fall. Instead of them racing to get up and beat the other to the finish line, they both helped each other up and push one another to finish the race. Afterwards, in an interview, one of the women made the statement, She helped me get back to the moment. I believe that is such a beautiful picture of what community does for one another. We all fall and even injure ourselves, but when we surround ourselves with a godly community, they bring us back to the moment. Back to the moment where we felt God's peace, joy, love, and purpose over our lives. We know that being in community is not the cure-all fix to our feelings of abandonment, but we must press into the heart of God and capture the hope He presents to His children. In the end of Psalm 22, we see David's attitude and language towards his situation change. Nothing about his problem or issues was different, but his perspective was hopeful. He had taken on the heart of the Father and had hope for the future. As you read and discuss Psalm 22 with your group, I pray that you would feel the release of judgment so that you can be vulnerable about what you are going through with the community God has surrounded you with. I pray you would grab onto the hope that our Father longs to give His children.